You look at these significant challenges that we face in agriculture, and you think, where are the new solutions? And one of the biggest untapped areas is microbes. Well, plants are filled with microbes. Plants grow in soil that's filled with microbes. A gram of soil can have 10 to the 10th different genomes, microbial genomes. And so when you consider a plant, it's actually a tiny ecosystem. And what we've gained the capacity to do over the last decade, really, is to study that plant ecosystem in way more detail than we've ever been able to study it before. And it's opening the door into understanding new ways that we can make healthy plants. One thing that we're interested in doing is making linkages between agricultural systems and native prairie systems. And one puzzle for us is, how have all those perennial herbaceous plants of the prairies remained healthy year after year? Why don't the pathogens wipe out the prairie, just like they can wipe out our monocultures or they can wipe out our agricultural crops? And the question is, are those microbial communities that plants normally create, are they conferring significant benefits to those plants? And by trying to disentangle what happens in that prairie, are there important lessons for agriculture? In the big picture, what I want to understand is how we can harness the potential of indigenous microbes to make healthier, more productive crops. Instead of spending all our time focusing on killing the bad guys, let's enhance the good guys. And an outcome of that, and we hope will be, reductions in pesticide use, reductions in the frequency of fumigation, the capacity to produce healthier crops with higher yields. Realistically, we see all of those as outcomes of our work.